Hey game developers, are you excited for Android L? My name is Shani, and this is What's New for Games. Google I.O. was just a few months ago, and we have announced some cool things, like Android TV, which works with a game controller. We also played with Cardboard for virtual reality, which you can assemble on your own from Cardboard. While it would be really cool to talk about bringing games to TV and virtual reality, I'm going to focus on these topics here. If you're familiar with the Google Play game services, it is interesting to note there are a few changes coming in. First, we took the cloud save feature and are giving it a facelift with saved games. Saved games offers an improved user experience, allowing you to upload up to 3 megabytes of game data with an additional cover image for the user to see, acting as a bookmark and reminding them where they left your game. But that's not all. We are also adding quests, which you can use to trigger events in your game. Quests are a fun way to make your game more alive and dynamic without having to download a game update. For example, how about a shiny new sword for 50 zombie heads this weekend? Awesome! Simply go to the developer console and declare a new quest and set up a reward for your players. Use them to engage your players and keep them active. For more information about the new features, check out Duncan's video on what's new in Google Play Games. The following features are coming up with the Android L SDK. You can already find them in the newest NDK release and the Android L preview. We are adding support for 64-bit architecture. 64-bit hardware has twice the number of registers and should boost your game's performance. To compile for it, you need to specify support for a target platform. We added explicit support for ARM, x86, and MIPS. Simply add the target APIs inside your application makefile, and you're good to go. A really cool addition for graphic programmers is the new OpenGL ES 3.1 API and the Android Extension Pack. We're really getting to desktop-level graphics here. This can be used to enhance your game's visuals and performance. The biggest change is in the pipeline, with the addition of 3 new shader stages. Let's take a more detailed look, starting with tessellation. Tessellation shaders take geometry and subdivides it, adding additional triangles, allowing you to increase the level of detail dynamically on the GPU. Thanks Qualcomm for this video. Geometry shaders, on the other hand, take a single vertex and can output multiple new vertices, making a new mesh or extending the existing one. These are great for particles, grass, and even shadows. And finally, compute shaders. This video by NVIDIA shows compute shaders being used for creating complex animations and effects entirely on the GPU. You can use compute shaders for many things, from complex physics, high quantity lights, and even AI. The last big change to graphics is the addition of ASTC texture support on the GPU. This means you can copy the texture's byte data straight to the graphics memory, reducing the memory footprint of your application and the loading times. Like all compressors, ASTC processes the texture and provides a lower-sized output, with some quality differences. Evaluating the difference map of the image shows ASTC is quite high quality, offering a good exchange between reduced size and speed compared to image quality loss. You can set different block footprint for compression. The larger the block, the smaller the image file, but more likely the image differences will be visible. Finally, we have improvements to the OpenSL Audio API. We have lowered the audio input latency, offering reduced lag between recording your audio and outputting it back to the user. You can finally make that mobile karaoke game you always wanted. We also added support for multi-channel mixing, allowing you to send your audio output to more than 2 channels. If you're expecting your game to be played with a surround system, for example, on Android TV maybe, you should really take a look at that. Finally, we added support for floating point buffers. These provide higher dynamic range, consistent accuracy, and more headroom. For more information on floating point in audio, take a look at Glenn's video. Will it float? Check out the new NDK 64-bit target from the Android developer's website to play with the new features. And don't forget, use Google Play Game Services to drive engagement in your games. Thank you for watching. Now go ahead and make your games even more fun and visually stunning with new features in Android L.